I'm Earnest Pettie, part of the Culture and Trends team at YouTube, and I also maintain my own channel. This video will help you learn to use the audience retention tool in YouTube Analytics. As a creator myself, I know how it can sometimes feel like you're putting out videos in a vacuum and trying to guess what it is people want to see, hoping that you hit on that one thing that works. With the audience retention tool, you don't have to feel like you're shouting into a void and waiting for an answer. You can see exactly what people viewing your videos like, what they don't like, and even what they love. Let's take a look. When you arrive at audience retention in analytics, the first thing you see is the average view duration and average percentage viewed for your channel. To look at specific videos, you can click on Video under the graph and click on the video that you want to analyze, or you can use the search bar. So this is a video that we did about shareability on YouTube. Now, you can see here that the video has an average view duration of 2 minutes and 49 seconds, and 65% is the average percentage viewed. That's well above our average percentage, so that's not bad. There are two tabs here. The first is absolute audience retention, which shows you how long people are watching your video. The second is relative audience retention. You can use it to help you understand how the retention you see in the absolute chart compares to other videos that are the same length. For this video, we're just going to focus on absolute audience retention. Looking at this graph, you can literally go through your video second by second to see precisely when people stopped watching. For this video, you can see a steep decline at the beginning and another sharp drop-off at about 4 minutes. If you click on these drop-offs, it will take you to the moment in the video where the drop-off has happened. Whenever you see an uptick, it's because people are re-watching that portion of the video or they're being directed to that moment. There's more stuff to play around with in the tool, but these are really the most important when it comes to understanding what your audience is responding to. Hopefully, by this point, you're starting to get a good feel for how useful the audience retention tool can be. Now I want to show you all the cool stuff it's telling you about your videos and how to use that information to improve them. Put simply, this tool is essentially instant feedback. It's telling you all sorts of vital information about your video, and in order to increase watch time for your videos, all you have to do is listen. We'll use the video we were just looking at as an example. With this video, we lost 18% of our viewers by the 13-second mark. That's a lot of people who never got to the good stuff. This is a good indication that maybe we don't need 13 seconds of introduction, and we can experiment with eliminating that in our next video. At 4 minutes and 5 seconds, we see the second steep decline. Navigating to that point in the timeline, we can see that this is the end card, so there's really no more content for people to consume here. We can try to do more to keep people engaged through the end card, or we might decide that no further action is needed. Right here, at 1 minute and 7 seconds, I see there's been an uptick from people rewinding or sharing my video at this point. When I click on it, I see that people were rewinding because of this graphic. That tells me that my audience liked that, and to me that means I should be putting more graphics and easy-to-consume information on the screen. Looking at audience retention like this can help you zero in on exactly what your audience wants to see, which will keep them around for longer. It's why we're showing you so many graphics, we use it ourselves. As you make improvements to your videos based on this information, you'll begin to see improvements in the average view duration and percentage viewed for your whole channel. Which is really what all of this is about, making videos that connect with and engage your audience. Below the audience retention graph is information on geography and device type. You can use the geography information to understand how long people from other countries are watching your videos. You might discover that something as simple as adding subtitles will dramatically increase your audience retention for countries in which you never expected to grow audiences. You can use device type to understand if your videos are equally consumable across all devices. If you're seeing mobile is dropping off at 30%, but desktop is watching for 55%, you can look at your videos on your phone to find out what it is that's making mobile users drop off. Maybe your font is too small. The audience retention tool is awesome. It's the only YouTube analytic that informs creative, makes you more in tune with your work and audience, and allows you to dig deeper into the why. Why didn't this work? Why did this work? People pay good money for information like that on TV, and yet you're getting it for free.